Hello friends, welcome to my channel My Engineering Stuffs. So today's tutorial is how to set up your particle photon for the first time. So before I start my tutorial, I would like to request friends, please subscribe my channel to support me, and if you like this video, please do not forget to hit that like button. So in today's tutorial, let's set up this particle photon board. So for that we will require one particle board, this is your particle board, and I will connect it to your small breadboard. I will use this cable to power up this particle board. And then let's open your App Store or in iOS or your Google Play. Play Store in your Android. Now search for particle. You need to download this application and open it. So now you need to click on get connected. As I have already set up this particle board with my account, so I need to click on I already have a particle account. If you are setting it for the first time, you need to sign up with a email ID, and you can create your account here only. So I will connect. I will write down my mail ID, credentials, then provide password, then log into it. Okay, for the first time it will ask for which device you want to set up. So here I am having photon board. I will connect it to photon. Now I will power up with this USB cable by connecting it to my laptop. Okay, so I have zoomed to my particle photon board. Now it's power up. Then after power up, you need to set the board to programming mode. So to set in programming mode, you need to press this reset button for 3 seconds, and when this board start blinking blue, you need to leave it. Right, then in the app side, just click on ready. Now you need to go to your setup, then click on Wi-Fi, and a Wi-Fi network of photon will shown here. So just click on it, it will connect, and it will ask you to go there. Fine, and it will connect to that board automatically, and app will ask you for the product ownership. It means that you are claiming this device with your Gmail ID, that your device will connect to your Gmail ID as your device with its unique ID. Now it's asking for whether this Wi-Fi network you want to program it, or if you have another, you can refresh it once again. As I am having this one only, I will click this, then I will give a password for my home Wi-Fi network. Done. So connect. Now the board will connect with my home Wi-Fi network with a SSID and password, and it will program by itself. So whenever the device will turn on, it will automatically search for the Wi-Fi network and it will connect to the Wi-Fi network. Then it will go to its particle.io server. Then it will fetch the data or give the data, means put the data. So after completing, it will ask you to give a device name. So I will give my device as my engineering stubs. Fine, then click on done. So now it's done. So whenever you are claiming your device or setting up your device for the first time, it will be get uploaded with a firmware called Tinker. Fine, and it will be like your layout as like your particle board. So let me set this D7 pin as your digital write. And why I'm setting this? Because in the board side, a onboard LED is connected at D7 pin. So whenever you will toggle this D7 pin too high, it will glow the LED in the device side, and whenever you will set it low, it will get off. Then you can play with this by turning on and off. Fine. Okay, now let's do one more example. We can connect one LED, means the positive side. Let's suppose I'm connecting this one to D1 and the negative side to ground. Okay, now it's connected to D1. So we will set this D1 pin as analog write, let's suppose. So by sliding this slider, we can increase or decrease the intensity of the light which is connected at your pin number D1. So let's increase. Fine. Then let's suppose decrease the intensity. So let's see, from here, as I'm increasing this one, the intensity of LED increases. As I'm decreasing, the intensity also decreases. So you can play with this thinker, or you can design your code to control this particle photon in anywhere in this world, because it is connected to internet. That's all in today's tutorial, guys. So thank you for watching.